The information provided in this video is intended for your general knowledge and is not a substitute for professional medical advice or treatment by your diabetes care provider or diabetes education by a diabetes care and education specialist. Hypoglycemia is a term that refers to low blood glucose, also called low blood sugar. Any blood glucose level less than 70 milligrams per deciliter is considered hypoglycemia. When the blood glucose level is low, steps should be taken to bring the level back up. Always check the blood glucose level before treating symptoms. In most cases of hypoglycemia, the person with diabetes is alert and can eat or drink enough to bring the blood glucose back up. Signs of hypoglycemia include feeling shaky, sweaty, or weak, hunger, pale skin color, confusion, irritability, or quick mood changes. When a person with diabetes has hypoglycemia and is able to eat or drink, use the 15-15 rule. The 15-15 rule. 1. Check the blood glucose level to make sure it is less than 70 milligrams per deciliter. 2. Give 15 to 20 grams of fast-acting carbohydrates, such as 4 glucose tablets, 1 tube of glucose gel, or 1/2 cup of juice. 3. Recheck the blood glucose level in 15 minutes. If the blood glucose level is still less than 70 milligrams per deciliter, repeat steps 1, 2, and 3 until the blood glucose level is greater than 70 milligrams per deciliter. With hypoglycemia, the person with diabetes may need some assistance. You can help by putting the person in a safe position, safe from falling, assisting them to check the blood glucose level, or checking it for them if they are unable, providing 15 grams of fast-acting carbohydrates, or directing the person to eat or drink. Severe hypoglycemia. If the person has severe hypoglycemia, the person will not be alert at all. They may be unconscious or have a seizure. This person will need help from an adult and will need glucagon to bring the blood glucose level up quickly. Glucagon is a hormone that tells the body to release glucose into the bloodstream. Glucagon is also a prescription medicine for severe hypoglycemic emergencies that should always be kept close. Glucagon can be given by injection into the skin or by spray into the nose. Instructions for giving glucagon should be reviewed with the medical provider or pharmacist when the prescription is received. To treat severe hypoglycemia with glucagon, 1. Put the hypoglycemic person in a safe position so they do not fall. 2. Administer glucagon per kit instructions. After glucagon is given, the person may feel nauseous and vomit. 3. After administering glucagon, call 911. 4. Check their blood glucose level. 5. Continue to check the blood glucose levels every 3 to 4 hours. Recovery time from severe hypoglycemia can take 2 to 12 hours. There is also a higher risk of additional low blood glucose levels over the next 24 hours. 6. Call your diabetes care team to report a severe hypoglycemic event for follow-up instructions. Hyperglycemia refers to high blood glucose, also called high blood sugar. When your body cannot get the energy it needs from glucose, the body begins to break down fat for energy. When fat is used for energy, acids called ketones are produced. Ketones are bad for the function of the entire body and can cause a dangerous and avoidable condition called diabetic ketoacidosis, or DKA. DKA can happen from not taking enough insulin or not taking insulin at all. Ketones also can be produced when not enough food or carbs are eaten to provide energy. For example, if a person eats only foods that contain fat and protein. The best rules to avoid producing ketones are: do not miss insulin doses, especially basal insulin, also called long-acting insulin, and eat a medium amount of carbohydrates, 45 to 60 grams, with breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Check for ketones when your blood glucose level is greater than 240 milligrams per deciliter for 2 scheduled checks in a row. When the meter reads high, for many meters, this means the blood glucose level is over 500 milligrams per deciliter. Or when you are sick, especially if you are vomiting. Knowing this information is an important part of your diabetes care. Diabetes education is essential for anyone to manage diabetes. To learn more about diabetes education and problem solving with diabetes, such as managing and treating hypo and hyperglycemia, contact Barnstable Brown Diabetes Education Services at 859-323-7391 or Diabetes Education Services at uky.edu.